I'd like to talk to you about ozone and peroxide. Now, that is quite an interesting situation. It happens that either ozone or peroxide, they're more or less similar. Okay, all of you know that water is H2O. Two H's and one O, right? That's water. Okay? Okay, now, if you add one extra O, and what have you got? Now you have H2O2, and that's peroxide, right? But the interesting thing is that while oxygen has two valences and is usually attached with two bonds, for instance, the plain oxygen gas that we're breathing all day long, okay, has the two oxygen, but they're connected with a double bond. And that's a pretty solid material that doesn't break down easily. Same with water. It's a very solid material, doesn't break down easily. Now you add another O, and instead of oxygen, you have ozone. Now you have the similar situation in both cases. This additional oxygen is attached with a single bond. Same here, single bond. And because it's attached with a single bond, it comes off easy. And it's very active. And it's extremely valuable. And that's what we use. We use a lot of the hydrogen peroxide. And what it does, okay, so we get that O radical. Yes, and it is a free radical, but it has wonderful capabilities. It does four things. I don't know if I can get them all on here. Number one, it kills germs and viruses. Okay, very good. And number two, it kills tumor tissue, cancer. Number three, it oxygenates the bloodstream. Now, sometimes they use hyperbaric oxygen chambers to pressure extra oxygen into the blood, but it's oxygen, it's not ozone. And the minute you get out of the chamber very quickly, you lose this extra oxygen, and it's the way it was. Not with the ozone. That extra ozone is much more capable of staying in the blood, and you still find it 72 hours later. So this is number three. It ozonates the blood. Therefore, makes it more active. And number four, because it's a free radical, it combines with other free radicals and makes toxic free radicals into excretable compounds. Okay, so it combines with free radicals. Therefore, this whole thing, this H2O2 and also ozone, is very valuable material. We use the peroxide. We give every patient when they come a bottle of peroxide to rub on their bodies every day, at least once, preferably twice. Because like every other thing you put on your skin, it's absorbed right into the bloodstream, and right away, this extra oxygen radical goes into the bloodstream. And it helps to kill germs and viruses, and it helps to kill tumor tissue, and it helps to oxygenate and ozonate the blood, and it helps to combine with free radicals. Very valuable, okay? Now, ozone can also be used, but it's a little more difficult. For ozone, you need a room ozone generator, which is very useful, but it's a little extra machine. It happens that peroxide is very cheap. Very cheap, very effective, very useful. Guess what Orthodox doctors think of it? No good. It's too cheap. Okay.
Do you have it on the skull as well?
Yeah, why do you want to put it on your hair? You're going to bleach it halfway. Don't try. Doesn't work. Okay? So, very, very valuable. And anything like this, which is harmless, does only good, helps the patient, and doesn't just have to be cancer. How about germs and viruses? What about chronic fatigue? What about all the other problems? What about the free radicals? What about the toxins? Yes. Yes, I know. You can put ozone in the bloodstream. I've had those treatments. But just for people to do at home, this is so easy. Okay? This is so easy, and they can carry on at home. They can take care of the patient, and it helps, and it's very useful. There are ways of putting the ozone into the bloodstream. I've had those treatments. Before we give anything to a patient, it's me first. You ever hear an oncologist say that for chemo? Wonder why.